she's dressing now.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Miss Sarah, and Miss Brittany's in the back. She's recording for Facebook Live. And today we're going to be talking about the first day of winter, because today is the first day of winter. So I'm so happy that you are all here with me. So let's get up and sing if you're happy and you know it. Let's get up. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, spin around. If you're happy and you know it, spin around. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, spin around. If you're happy and you know it, sit right down. If you're happy and you know it, sit right down. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, sit right down. Great job! All right, we're going to start off today by reading a book called The Shortest Day, which is by Susan Cooper. We're reading this book because we start, the first day of winter happens on the winter solstice, which is the shortest day of the year. So this book is all about a celebration that happens on the first, on the shortest day of the year. See some pretty pictures. Yeah. Even more, they're picking up some sticks. So the shortest day came. And the year died. And everywhere down the centuries of the snow-white world came people singing, dancing to drive the dark away. They lighted candles in the winter trees. They hung their homes with evergreen. They burned fires all night long to keep the year alive. And when the New Year's sunshine blazed awake, they shouted, reveling. Through all the frosty ages, you can hear them echoing behind us. Listen. All the long echoes sing the same delight. This shortest day, as promise wakens in the sleeping lands. They carol, feast, give thanks, and dearly love their friends and hope for peace. And so do we, here now, this year and every year, we welcome Yule. And that's the end. Welcome to Yule. All right, let's get up and we'll sing a song. All right, so it's winter time, so snow's gonna be coming, hopefully. So we're gonna take our fingers and we're gonna make some snowflakes. Yeah, can we make snowflakes? Move them all around. All right, we're gonna sing. Dance like snowflakes, dance like snowflakes, falling down, falling down. Whirling, twirling snowflakes, whirling, twirling snowflakes, falling down. falling down. All right, you want to do it again? Now we know the motions. We'll go. Dance like snowflakes, dance like snowflakes, falling down, falling down. Whirling, twirling snowflakes, whirling, twirling snowflakes, falling down, falling down. Great job! You are all very great snowflakes. Let's stay standing. We'll do one more, okay? All right, so this one's a finger play, and it's all about snow-covered hills. Who likes to go sledding? Yeah, do you like to go sledding? So hopefully we'll be able to go sledding this year on some snow-covered hills. So we'll go, here is a hill, and here is another. They're covered in snow. So I'll put on my coat and jump on my sled, and then we'll go down the hill. All right, you want to try one more time? We have, here is a hill, here is another, and they're all covered in snow. So I'll put on my coat and jump on my sled, and then we'll go down the hill. Yeah, great job. All right, so we're gonna do a little flannel board story about someone else who likes to go sledding, okay? And this is a story based off a really famous book. It's called The Snowy Day. You can see it up there. We have our little polar bears reading it too. So let's read it together. It's The Snowy Day, and it is by Ezra Jack Keats. So one morning, Peter woke up and he looked out the window. Snow had fallen as far as he could see. It covered everything. He's looking out the window. Look at all that snow out there he can see. After breakfast, he's going to put on his snowsuit. Yeah, he has this bright red snowsuit. And he runs outside. And outside, the snow was piled up very high along the street, but there was a path that he could walk down. Crunch, 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 his feet sank into the snow. He walked with his toes pointed out like this. Can you walk with your toes pointed out like this? You want to get up and try? All right, and then next he walked with his toes pointed in like this. Crunch, crunch, crunch through that snow. And then he dragged his feet really slow to make tracks in the snow. Yeah, you know when you walk in the snow and you can see all your footprints? And then he found something sticking out of the snow that could make another path. He found a stick. So he started to drag his stick along with him to make another track in the snow. Down fell the snow, plop, on top of Peter's head. Oh no! He thought it would be fun to join the big boys in their snowball fights, but he knew he wasn't old enough quite yet. Yeah, you see the big boys? They're doing a little snowball fight back there. So instead, he made a smiling snowman in the snow. And then he made some snow angels. Has anybody here made a snowman? You made snowman? What about a snow angel? Has anyone made a snow angel where you lie down and go like this? Yeah, that's lots of fun. And then Peter pretended that he was a mountain climber. He climbed up great big heaping tall mountains of snow. And then he slid all the way down. He picked up a handful of snow and another and still another. He packed it round and firm and put the snowball in his pocket for tomorrow. Do you think that's going to work? No, probably not. It's gonna melt. Yeah, it's going to melt. Then he went into his warm house, and he told his mother all about his great adventures, and she took off his wet socks. And he thought and thought about them, before he got into bed and he looked into his pocket. What do you think he's going to find in his pocket?
Wet.
Yeah, just some water. His pocket was empty. The snowball wasn't there. His pockets were all wet. Yeah, you're right, it melted. And he was very sad. And while he slept, he dreamt that the sun had melted all of the snow away. But when he woke up, his dream was gone, and he looked out the window. What do you think he might have seen out the window? Yeah, and the snow was still everywhere, and new snow was falling. After breakfast, he called to his friend across the hall, and they went out after breakfast in the deep, deep snow. The end. All right, let's get up and we'll sing one more song. All right, so this one has some different verses. In each verse, we're going to do a different action. So we'll start with the first one. We're going to rub our arms like we're cold. All right, are you chilly? Shiver a little bit. All right, and it goes like this. Come sing a song of winter, of winter, of winter. Come sing a song of winter. The cold days are here. Okay, rub your arms like you're cold. With winter winds blowing and rosy cheeks glowing, come sing a song of winter, the cold days are here. All right, and this time it's gonna snow, so we gotta get our snowflake hands ready again. You know how we do our snowflakes. Come sing a song of winter, of winter, of winter. Come sing a song of winter, the cold days are here. With snowfall and snowmen and icicles frozen. Come sing a song of winter, the cold days are here. All right, and this time we're gonna go skating. Who's been ice skating? Has anyone been ice skating? You've been ice skating? Well, let's go ice skating together. So when we go ice skating, we slide our feet on the ground like we're sliding around. So get ready to slide. Come sing a song of winter, of winter, of winter. Come sing a song of winter, the cold days are here. With skating and skiing and everything freezing. Come sing a song of winter, the cold days are here. All right, this is our last one. And this one, we're gonna wrap ourselves up in a nice warm blanket and be nice and snuggly warm, all right? Come sing a song of winter, of winter, of winter. Come sing a song of winter, the cold days are here. And after the sledding comes warm, cozy bedding. Yes, we gotta wrap ourselves up in the blanket. Come sing a song of winter, the cold days are here. Great job! All right, we're gonna read one more book. And this one is called The First Day of Winter, which is today. Yeah, it's not snowing today, but maybe sometime this winter. So this book is called The First Day of Winter, and it was written by Denise Fleming. And this one is all about building a snowman. Look, it's just a bare snowman. Doesn't have any decorations. We got to decorate that snowman. On the first day of winter, my best friend gave to me. What do you think we're going to give the snowman? A red cap with a gold snap. On the second day of winter, my best friend gave to me. Two bright blue mittens and a red cap with a gold snap. On the third day of winter, my best friend gave to me three striped scarves, two bright blue mittens, and a red cap with a gold snap.
Do you think the snowman needs three scarves? I think that's a lot of scarves.
On the fourth day of winter, my best friend gave to me four prickly pine cones. They're up here. Three striped scarves, two bright blue mittens, and a red cap with a gold snap. On the fifth day of winter, my best friend gave to me five birdseed pockets. You see them? We have one, two, three, four, five, and they're all filled with birdseed. You only see two, there are five. One, two, three, four, five. Four prickly pine cones, three striped scarves, two bright blue mittens, and a red cap with a gold snap. On the sixth day of winter, my best friend gave to me six tiny twigs, five birdseed pockets, four prickly pine cones, three striped scarves, blue, two bright blue mittens, and a red cap with a gold snap. See, the snowman's coming together. On the seventh day of winter, my best friend gave to me seven maple leaves, six tiny twigs, five birdseed pockets, four prickly pine cones, three striped scarves, two bright blue mittens, and a red cap with a gold snap. On the eighth day of winter, my best friend gave to me eight orange berries, seven maple leaves, six tiny twigs, five birdseed pockets, four prickly pine cones, three striped scarves, two bright blue mittens, and a red cap with a gold snap.
What did they make with the berries? Do you see on his, what's on his face now? Yeah, the berries, he has a little smile. He's a smiling snowman.
On the ninth day of winter, my best friend gave to me nine big black buttons, eight orange berries, seven maple leaves, six tiny twigs, five birdseed pockets, four prickly pine cones, three striped scarves, two bright blue mittens, and a red cap with a gold snap.
Yeah, our snowman's almost done. We got one more, though.
Yeah, on the 10th day of winter, my best friend gave to me 10 salty peanuts, 9 big black buttons, 8 orange berries, 7 maple leaves, 6 tiny twigs, 5 birdseed pockets, 4 prickly pine cones, 3 striped scarves, two bright blue mittens, and a red cap with a gold snap.
Yeah, and look, it's our completed snowman. Give him a clap. Yeah, and that's the end. We have the snowman. All right, speaking of scarves, who wants to come up here and grab a scarf from me? Do you want to get a scarf?
Thank you, sweetie.
You want a blue one? There you go. Hey, Bingsley, do you want a scarf?
She wasn't having it this morning.
Do you want some scarves?
Thank you, Miss Sarah.
Yes.
There you go, Bangs.
Purple one. Hey, do you want to grab a scarf? What color? In the yellow? Here, can you take this red scarf? Do you want to take that? There you go. Good job. All right. All right. We're going to take our scarves and we're going to do a little motion activity about all the different weather we might get in the winter.
So our scarves are going to be our weather. So first we're going to do rain. So sometimes it rains in winter, just like yesterday. Yeah, so we have rain on the ground. Can we wave our scarves on the ground? And we have rain on the trees. And we'll take it like this. We have rain on the roof. But there's no rain on me. Can you rub it on your head? Good job. All right. What's some other weather we might get in the winter?
Snow.
Snow. All right. So we'll do snow next. We have snow on the ground. We have snow in the trees. And we have snow on the roof. Who wants to make a rooftop? Hold it between your hands like this and make a rooftop. But there's no snow on me. Yeah. What's some other weather we might get in the winter? I don't think that's a type of weather. What about sunshine? Do we sometimes get sunshine in the winter? All right, so we have sunshine on the ground. And sunshine in the trees. Sunshine lands on the roof. Who wants to make a roof? Make a roof. But there's no sunshine on me. All right, what about wind? Sometimes it's windy in the winter. Yeah, but sometimes the wind can blow through the grass. So we want to put it on the ground? Yeah, we have it wind blowing in the air. You're right. And sometimes you can hear the wind blowing on your roof. Do you hear that sometimes? And it sounds like it's whistling? Yeah, but when you're inside, there's no wind on you. All right. Great job. I think that's all the kinds of winter. All the kinds of weather that we get in winter. So who wants to keep their scarves and we'll listen to a couple songs with them. We can do a dance.
D-I-N-G-O and Zingo was his name. Now
what he spelled the word D-I-N-G-O
instead of saying the letter D.
Let's dance with Emma. That's what this song is. Yeah, who's ready to dance with their scarves? Switch hands. You want to twirl it? Twirl around. You want to spin around with me? Yeah, good job. Great job. Great dancing. All right. Let's come put our scarves up here. Can we come put them right here?
Yeah.
Make a pile. Good job. Good job, Bingsley. Right. You have a question? Yeah. All right. I have a couple of announcements before we sing our goodbye song. So the library is going to be closed starting tomorrow, but we'll be back on Tuesday next week. And we are going to be having story time next week, so be sure to come. We have it on both Wednesday and Thursday. Is there going to be snow? I don't think so, but maybe in January. Maybe we'll get some snow in January. All right, let's get up and get ready to say goodbye. We wave and sing goodbye. We wave and sing goodbye. With our friends at story time, we wave and sing goodbye. We clap and sing goodbye. We clap and sing goodbye. With our friends at story time, we clap and sing goodbye. We stomp and sing goodbye. We stomp and sing goodbye. With our friends at story time, we stomp and sing goodbye. Who remembers what the next one is? We smile. We smile and sing goodbye. We smile and sing goodbye. With our friends at story time, we smile and sing goodbye. Goodbye, everybody. And make